Hello friends, in today's video lecture we are going to learn about software as a service. It called as SaaS, SaaS. Now how software as a service is connected to in our software engineering. In software engineering, what is called SaaS, that is, suppose we are going to make product as a software, right? And it is delivered to some on-demand services, right? Then it's called software as a service in software engineering. Now let's see about SaaS. So what is SaaS? It is nothing but it is a on-demand service, right? We can also say that SaaS is on-demand services platform, right? And what are the definition of SaaS? That is, it is a software deliver method. This method provide access to software and it function as a web-based service, right? Now SaaS allows organization to access business functionality at a cost typically less than paying for licensed application, right? It means that because of that license application, pricing of SaaS is based on monthly fee. These licensed applications, it is a SaaS based and it is a monthly fee. That's why SaaS allowing organized to access business functionality at a cost typically than paying for licensed application. Now this service is hosted remotely. Users don't need to invest in additional hardware. The most common requirement for SaaS is only internet connection plus web browser. We only require internet and web browser. This way we can hosted the service remotely for users. Now modern SaaS system are easier to customer as per your business needs. Means buyers can customize the UI to change the look and feel of the program as well as modify specify areas such as data fields to alter what data appears. Several business process feature can also be turned off and on at will, right? This way modern system are easier to customer as per your business need. Now what are the benefits of SaaS? Let's see first benefit, that is cost effective. Now why SaaS is cost effective? Because there is availability of service with less cost and no hardware installation. That's why we can say it is a cost effective, right? Because it's availability of service with less cost and no hardware installation overhead. That's why is cost effective. Now second way is easy to administration, means it is easier for administration work, right? Now third one is upgrade and security. The SaaS vendors is responsible for upgrade. Upgrade, uptime and security of the data and service. Security of data and services. That's why it benefit to upgrade and security. Now fourth one is easy to adopt. As the software is accessible via familiar web browsers, right? It is familiar to web browser and SaaS app and SaaS apps tend to have lower learning curves and higher adoption rates. That's why it is easy to adopt, right? Fifth one is customization. Then most of the SaaS application allow some amount of customization. Now last one is work anywhere. Since the software is hosted in the cloud and accessible over the internet, user can access it anywhere. Why it work anywhere? Because any software is hosted in the cloud, right? It's hosted in the cloud and accessible over the internet, right? Accessible over the internet, and user can access from anywhere, right? User can access from anywhere. That's why it's work anywhere. So these are the benefit of SaaS, right? Now let's see example of SaaS. Real-time examples of SaaS. For example, best and most important SaaS example is that FB, right? Facebook, Twitter. These all are the examples, real-time example of SaaS. Then some providers have platform for social media, right? That is FB and Twitter, like this. Similarly, ASP.NET, that is active server pages, is also example of SaaS because it is having a programming framework, and in which language it will be built, CLR, that is common language runtime, right? So similarly, enterprise Java Beans, Java Server Pages and Rails, right? These all are the real-time example of SaaS. Now let's see SaaS architecture, how SaaS works. The SaaS uses an approach in which the software is developed as a host service and is accessed over the internet. Basically, SaaS architecture has five layers. The first one is presentation layer, second application layer, third one is security layer, fourth one is operation layer, and fifth one is backend layer. Now let's see architecture of SaaS. For example, this figures shows the architecture of SaaS. The SaaS uses an approach in which the software is developed as a host service and is accessed over the internet, right? This is shown in figure. Now basically it has four layers, that is presentation layer. First one is presentation, second is application layer, third one is security layer, fourth one is operation layer, and fifth one is backend layer. Now presentation layer, it contains the capabilities that are exposed to the user. It has capability to exposed to user. Now this user interaction is possible via menu navigation, user control and reporting, right? This controls is monitoring the reports. This way user interact with possible reports or you can say user controls. This way presentation layer works. Now second one is application layer. It is a business layer. This application layer is also known as business layer, and it lies between presentation and backend. This application layer lies between presentation layer and backend layers, right? It handles the user profile, manages the workflow of users and make data synchronized and exception handling task, right? This way application layer work. Now third one is security layer. This is the most required layer in SaaS architecture, most important layer in SaaS architecture, and it has a data in one wire, the authentication and authorization users, the authentication and authorization users and data encryption, and data encryptions are some important tasks of this layer. Means security layer performed this user authentications and data encryption, right? This way security layer work. Now fourth one is operations layer. These operations are basically capability that are required to keep SaaS application running. This operation layer work for SaaS applications running. And whatever applications are there for SaaS, operation layer work for running these all application, right? We can say running, pulling, or we can say monitoring the required data components to configure or customizing the data or operation as per the business requirement. Availability of components, that performance checks are some important tasks that are handled by operations layer, right? So this way operation layer work. Now what is the importance of operation layer? It checks the performance important tasks that are handled by these layers, right? Now fifth one is backend. This layer is responsible for the capabilities that are required for storing the data. Storing the data. Backend is used for to how we can store the data, and this layer responsible for storing data and moving it around the network, right? The database storage, computation and code execution, networking and communication are important activities that are carried out in this backend layer, right? So whatever data are stored in cloud, it will be handled by backend. Now I hope that you all are clear with SaaS architecture. It has mainly five tasks. That first one is presentation layer, second is application layer, third is security layer, fourth is operation layer, and fifth is backend layers. Now let's see what are the advantage of SaaS. It is easy to use, scalability, vendor accountability, right? These all are the advantage of SaaS, right? What are the disadvantage of SaaS? It is a robustness, privacy, security, reliability and performance. These all are disadvantage of SaaS. Now what are the providers of SaaS? SaaS providers are, we are aware with LinkedIn, right? This LinkedIn we already used for download the official data, right? Like power presentation PDF file. This is the official site, and these are the SaaS providers. And another SaaS providers are Salesforce, Workday, NetSuite, ServiceNow, Concurrent Technologies, right? These all are the software as a service providers. And this way SaaS will be work. I hope you all are clear with SaaS architecture. Thank you for watching.